Good morning, everyone. We studied in the previous video about the approximation to the nearest tens or hundred or thousand, 10,000, 100,000. What the meaning of approximation? Approximation means rounding to the nearest number, to the nearest tens or to the nearest hundred or to the nearest thousand and so on. When we approximate to the nearest tens, we add zero and approximate the next digit. When we approximate to the nearest hundreds, we put two zeros, 1,000, 3 zeros, 10,000, 4 zeros, 100,000, 5 zeros, and look to the digit beside them. We divide our digits into groups. Some of them are poor and some of them are rich. Our poor digits, 0, 1, 2, 3, and 4. Those are poor digits. We cancel them and don't add any thing. But our rich digits are 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. Those are rich digits. We cancel them and add one to the next digit. Let's see our lesson for today about the approximation to the nearest units and tens. Firstly, approximation to the nearest units. In this lesson, we will deal with the mixed number and the decimal number. We will deal with mixed number and the decimal number. We want to approximate any decimal number or any mixed number to the nearest units. To the nearest units mean to the nearest whole number. Firstly, approximate to the nearest units or to the nearest whole number. Now I have this example, 64.4. This is a mixed, this is a decimal number. I want to approximate it to the nearest units. So we will do what? Firstly, we will circle the units place. This is our units. We will approximate it to the nearest units. What's the meaning of approximation to the nearest units? To the nearest whole number. So we will do what? We will build a hole as usual. Build a hole. A hole. وبعدين look to the neighbor, which is 4. 4 is poor or rich. Yes, 4 is a poor digit. So we will cancel it and add only the whole number, which is 64. So 64.4 is approximately equal 64. Okay, let's see another example. 24.5. I said that we will circle the units place, which is 4, and build a wall, and look at its neighbor, which is the 10th place here. 5. 5 is poor or rich? Yes, 5 is rich digit. So we will cancel it and add 1 to the units place. So 24.5 is approximately equal to what? 25. We add 1 to the 4. It will become 25. Okay, let's see another example. 36.92. 36.92, I'll circle, I want to approximate this decimal number into the nearest units. So I look, I'll circle the units place and build a wall. And look at the neighbor, which is 9. 9, poor or rich? Yes, 9 is a rich digit. So I'll cancel it and add 1 to the units place, so it becomes 37. And this is our how to approximate the decimal number into whole number without any decimal places. Okay, we have here, this is not a decimal number, no, it's a mixed number because it has a whole number and a fraction. Okay, how can we approximate it to the nearest whole number? I look to my fraction. It has another way to answer this question. Okay, let's see how to answer this, how to approximate the fraction into a whole number. I look to the numerator. I have two ways. I can change it into decimal number, or I can answer it by this way. Look at how to answer it by this way. I look up to our numerator and multiply by 2. 1 times 2 equal what? Equal 2. Okay, only our numerator. 1 times 2 equal 2. This 2 is, I compare it between it and the denominator. 2 and 4. 2 is less than or greater than 4? No, it's less than 4. So it less than 4 or it less than our denominator. So we will cancel all the fraction and it will be approximately equal to 34. I'll cancel all the fraction because if I multiply the numerator by 2 and get the result is less than the denominator, I'll cancel all the fraction and the result will be is approximately equal to 34. Now let's see here, I have a fraction. 14 over 20. I want to approximate it to the nearest units or to the nearest whole number. This is 14 over 20. 14 over 20, I have two ways. The first one, as it's a fraction, I can change it into a decimal as we do what now? Here, I have 20. I'll divide 14 and 20 both into, I'll simplify this fraction. I simplify this fraction, 14 divide 2 equal 7 and 20 divide 2 equal, here our sign will be equal. 14 divide 2 equal 7 and 20 divide 2 equal 10. This is our fraction. I can, طبعاً هنا, 7 over 10, I can convert it into decimal by half here is 10, so it will be 0.7. Okay, I have here a decimal and I want to approximate it to the nearest units or to the nearest whole number. Top here I don't have here units place. I have here only zero. By the same way, I built up a wall and look at its neighbor, which is 7. 7 is rich or poor. Yes, 7 is rich. So I cancel it and add 1 to this 0. It will be approximately equal to 1. Okay? طيب. And another example, 55 over 50. I can simplify it also. 55 and 50 both in table 5. So I can divide them by 5. 55 divide 5 equal 11 and 50 divide 5 equal 10. I have here improper fraction. I want to convert it into decimal. Here I have only 10, so our decimal point will be after one digit, so it will be 1.1. 1.1, this is a decimal number and I want to approximate it to the nearest units, so I circle the units in place and built a wall and look, it's a neighbor. 1 is rich or poor? Yes, it's poor. So I cancel it and don't add anything. So it will be is approximately equal to only 1. Okay, I have here another example, 5 over 2. 5 over 2, it's an improper fraction. I can answer it by two ways. I can change this improper fraction into decimal number and I can answer it by this way. Let's see the other example, 5 over 2. I want to change it into decimal number to approximate it to the nearest whole number. Here I have 5 over 2. How can we change it into decimal number? By multiply both numerator and denominator by 5. 5 times 5 equal 25. And 2 times 5 equal 10. I have here 25 over 10. This is improper fraction. I can easily change it into decimal number. How can? I have here the denominator 10. So the decimal point after will be after one digit. So it will be 2.5. Okay, how can we approximate this decimal number into the nearest whole number? I'll circle the units place and build a wall. And look at its neighbor, 5. 5 is poor or rich? Yes, 5 is rich. So I'll cancel it and add 1 to the units place. It becomes approximately equal to 3. The 2 becomes 3. So 2.5 is approximately equal to 3. Let's see our second part of our lesson. Approximation to the nearest tenth. We note that approximation to the nearest tenth means approximation to the nearest one decimal place. يعني سواء كان the word tenth or the word one decimal place, both are the same meaning. Approximation to the nearest tenth. How can we approximate to the nearest tenth? Where is the tenth place? Where the tenth place? Yes, the tenth place is after the decimal point from this direction here. I inserted the tenth place. And look to what? Look to the its neighbor, which is 3. اللي هي ايه بنسميها الهندرث place. الهندرث here 3. 3 is rich or poor? Yes, 3 is poor. So we will cancel it and write only the number without 3. It will be 63.3. 63.33 is approximately equal to 63.3. Okay. How can we answer the second question? 422.762. Where is the 10th place? I want to approximate this number into the nearest 10th. Where is the 10th place? Circle it. Yes, circle it. And look at its neighbor. Look at its neighbor. Here, our 6 is the neighbor. 6 is poor or rich digit? Yes, it's rich digit. So we will cancel it and add 1 to the 10th place. So our result will be 422.7? No, it's 8. Why 8? Because 6 is rich. So we cancel it and add 1 to the 10th place. Okay, now we approximate to the nearest 10th. Here I have 367 and 3/4. How can we approximate it to the nearest 10th? طب لو احنا عندنا 10th يبقى I must have a decimal number. We have here a mixed number, so I'll change the fraction into decimal. How can? 4. Her sister is what? Yes, 25. We will multiply the 4 by 25 and multiply also the numerator by 25. I get here, I change the sign into equal. 367 and 3 times 25 equal what? Equal 75. And 4 times 25 equal 100. Yes. Now I can easily change in this number into decimal number. Yes. How can we change it? It will be 367 as the same. And here I have 2 zeros. So the decimal point will be after 2 digits. So it will be 367.75. And this is our decimal number. We will look our to our decimal number and approximate it to the nearest 1 decimal place, which is 7. We will look to the 7, I'll circle the 7. And look at its neighbor, which is 5. If 5 is poor or rich? Yes, it's rich. So I'll cancel it and add 1 to the 10th place. So our result will be 367.7. No, it's 8. Okay, clear? Yes. Here I have another example, 24 and 9/10. 9/10, here I have the denominator 10, so I can easily change it into decimal number. How can 24 and 9/10, from its name 9/10, it will be like this, the decimal point after 1 digit, because I have here 10. Okay, 24.9. How can I change it into the, how can I approximate it to the nearest decimal place or 1 decimal place? Here already 24.9, it's here, is approximately equal to the nearest tens. And the same, because I haven't here any hundreds. It's approximately equal to 24.9. Okay, here the next example, 37 and 1/4 and quarter. How can I change? I must change that mixed number into decimal number by multiplying the both numerator and denominator by 25. 1 times 25 equal 25, and 4 times 25 equal 100. Okay, and it will be 37.25. How can I change or I approximate it to the nearest whole, to the nearest 1 decimal place or to the nearest 10th? By looking to the 10th place, circle it and look its neighbor. 5 is add a rich or poor? Yes, it's rich. So I cancel it and add 1 to the 10th place, so it will be 37.3. Okay, our extra exercise, all of them will be homework. Okay, thanks.